To some people around the world, being in the water is nearly as important to their existence as drinking water. Some people swim, some boat, some water ski, and still others parasail. And then there are seaplanes. Add a set of floats to a normally certified land airplane, and you create an amphibian, a machine that offers retractable wheels on the floats or attached to the sides of the hull for full operations on the water or on the land. While there are a couple of restrictions on where a seaplane can operate from in the U.S., there's nothing like taking off from a traditional airport, landing on a lake 200 miles away, and beaching a seaplane in front of the cabin you rented for the week. Don't have time for a 5-hour drive to your favorite fishing spot? Try landing a seaplane on the lake, catching something incredible, and being home in time for dinner. While seaplanes offer dozens of new places to stop for that $100 fish, they do demand expanding your flying knowledge some. I remember my first experience with seaplane oddities during my first lesson. I started the engine just after I untied the seaplane from the dock, and as soon as the propeller began to spin, the airplane started moving in the water. And aircraft in the water don't have brakes, although most do come with a water rudder. Seaplane training demands learning lots of boating terms, like bow, stern, and buoyancy, as well as the effects of currents, centrifugal force, and of course the wind. You'll learn about the plow taxi, a maneuver that uses a high power setting to turn the airplane on the water against the wind. To me though, the takeoff and the landing were most magical. A seaplane at full power acts just like a speedboat plowing through the water. The difference is with a seaplane, the trick is to quickly transition from plowing along where water resistance is high to putting the airplane on the step, a point where the airplane skims along the water's surface like a flat stone does when tossed from shore. As speed increases, there comes a point where just a bit of back pressure on the stick makes the airplane fly. Now the seaplane behaves much like any other airplane. You just need to remember that an airplane with floats creates quite a bit of drag. Pull the throttle of a float plane to idle, and the airplane comes down quickly. I found that mastering the intricacies of a seaplane were a lot like understanding how to handle a tail dragger. It takes a fine touch on the controls at times, and a knack for understanding what the airplane is telling you through the vibrations you feel and the noises you hear. Once you do, though, the adventure you'll experience with a seaplane rating becomes an incredible combination of boating and flying. A big thanks goes out to the folks at Progressive Aero and Icon Aircraft for some of these video clips. You can find more information about them on the web, as well as the dozens of other seaplanes being created around the world. And don't forget to check out the Seaplane Pilots Association. For Flying Magazine, I'm Rob Mark in Chicago. We'll see you next time.